He could end up spending the rest of his life behind bars for spilling the government's secrets. The court-martial trial begins today for Private First Class Bradley Manning, the American soldier who has already admitted to helping to make public more than 700,000 war-related and classified U.S. documents through the secret-sharing website WikiLeaks. Manning is accused of aiding the enemy. Prosecutors today said the government will provide evidence indicating that materials al-Qaeda operators delivered to bin Laden can be traced to Manning's illicit downloading and transmission to WikiLeaks. But Manning still has a lot of supporters who see him as a victim of an overly secretive government. They argue, were it not for Manning, the public would not know the truth about when this U.S. Apache gunship killed Reuters reporters and civilians in Iraq in this helicopter strike in 2007. Manning has also found what some might consider an ally in the new documentary, We Steal Secrets, the story of WikiLeaks. Filmmaker Alex Gibney joins me now from New York. Alex, thanks so much for being here. Your documentary centers both on Manning's life and on the exploits of Julian Assange, creator of WikiLeaks. Let's take a quick look.
Disclosures like these tear at the fabric of responsible government.
We're looking at all of the things that we can do to stem the flow of this information.
This was the biggest leak in the history of this particular planet.
So my name is Julian Assange. I'm the editor of WikiLeaks.
We help you get the truth out. If you get this material, give it to us, no questions asked, and you'll help change history.
There was this kid who had reached out in confidence and said, hey, I'm leaking secrets.
It's a compelling and controversial documentary. It casts Manning as a sympathetic character, Alex. He uses his security clearance to make public some moments of the wars in Iraq and Afghanistan that he believes were unconscionable, particularly the deaths of innocents and civilians. But what do you think about the charge that his actions put the lives of other innocents at risk, including Iraqis and Afghans with whom the U.S. worked?
Well, are you talking about the charge aiding the enemy that the government is now charging him with in the trial?
I mean just putting out in the public names of individuals in Afghanistan and Iraq that the U.S. was working with that maybe would not have been known to the Taliban or to Iraqi insurgents beforehand.
Well, I think it may have been somewhat naive of Private Manning to have leaked documents without knowing precisely how they might be handled by WikiLeaks, and some of those documents were not properly redacted. But let's also say that nobody was actually hurt by their release. So I think, you know, it's fair to say that he was a little bit naive about the use to which they would be put. But I also think that he actually, this was not a data dump. He actually scrutinized these documents and had some sense of the fact that they would not hurt anybody in an operational sense, and furthermore, would shed some light, not only on the damage which had been done in Iraq and Afghanistan, but also on some rather good things that had been done by American diplomats around the world.
Some of the fans of Julian Assange take issue with your documentary and the portrayal of Assange. How do you view him?
Well, I think Julian Assange actually is admirable in many ways. I think the WikiLeaks platform as a publisher and as also an anonymous leaking site where you could send documents anonymously, I think that was an important precedent to be set. I think the problem with Assange was that he ended up bungling his own operation, in part by conflating his own personal misdeeds with the transparency agenda, and that's where I lost some sympathy with him.
The film also talks about how Private Manning was kept in a cell, a 6-by-8-foot cell, for 9 months. Do you think that the U.S. government has been cruel to Private Manning?
Yes. I think what the U.S. government has done to Private Manning has been outrageous, absolutely outrageous. And I think it's particularly outrageous that it happened during the Obama administration that pledged to be on the side of whistleblowers and indeed that pledged to be on the side of human rights. So his treatment both in Kuwait, as you mentioned, and also being kept in solitary confinement, having his clothes removed, having his glasses removed, being forced to stand naked before guards. These are, and the lights on all the time, these were techniques that were not unlike what was done to try to muscle information out of people in Guantanamo, for example. So I think what was done to Bradley Manning was absolutely cruel and unusual punishment.
All right, Alex Gibney, thank you so much. The film is We Steal Secrets, the story of WikiLeaks. Check it out. We'll have you back again sometime, Alex. As for Bradley Manning, his trial is ongoing. We'll cover all angles of the story as it progresses, hearing from many different voices.